In this video, we're going to discuss what's called interval notation. So here we have a number line, and I have a parenthesis on a negative 3 and a parenthesis on the positive 2. And notice that between the negative 3 and the positive 2, I have shading. This is what we call a graph of a set. Okay, and it's denoting basically all the numbers between negative 3 and positive 2. Let's write that down. It's all the numbers between negative 3 and positive 2. And so there's a more convenient way of denoting all those numbers. Well, first of all, how many numbers are there between negative 3 and positive 2? The answer is infinite. And the reason is because not only does it include, 0 and 1 and negative 1 and negative 2, it also includes like negative 1.5 and 0.6 and 0.67 and so on. So anywhere you put your pencil down, there's a number included in this set. Now the set does not include negative 3 and positive 2, however, and I know that because parentheses are used. So we have an infinite set of numbers between negative 3 and 2, not including negative 3 and 2 themselves. Now there's a more convenient way of denoting this set. And what we do is this. We use a parenthesis on the left because a parenthesis was used here, and we put a negative 3, comma, 2, and use a parenthesis after the 2 because a parenthesis was used here. This is called interval notation. So interval notation is the same, it denotes the same set of numbers that the graph denotes. It's just a more convenient way to do so. And remember, the parentheses are included, or used rather, because negative 3 and positive 2 are not included. So there are an infinite number of numbers in this collection because these two collections are the same. Let's try this one. Let's represent, we have a graph right now. Let's represent this set of numbers using interval notation. So we're going to write this, right? We're going to use a bracket, negative 2, comma, and then a 1. Now, what do you think the meaning of the bracket is on the negative 2? You may guess correctly that that means that negative 2 is also included. So bracket means included. So the negative 2 is included in the set. However, you can see because we're using a parenthesis here that the 1 is not included. So once again, we have all the numbers between negative 2 and positive 1, but also including the number negative 2. Okay, so this would be the interval representation of this set, which is graphed. Let's try a couple more. Okay, so I have three examples for us. Now, let's go back to the previous one for a moment. Notice that here, negative 3 is the lowest number, and 2 is the highest number. So the number on the left is always the lowest in interval notation, and the number on the right is always the highest. Always. Okay? So let's go back to our the examples we were just going to consider. Okay, here I see that indeed there is a lowest number, right? So that lowest number would be negative 2, and I'm going to use a parenthesis to indicate negative 2 is the lowest, but it's not included. Now I can see that there's no highest number, right? Because the shading keeps going and there's an arrow, and the arrow indicates keep on going, right? So, or keep going. So there is no highest number. And when that happens, we use a symbol to denote no highest number. And here's the symbol. It's what's called the infinity symbol. And when you write the infinity symbol, by convention, we use a parenthesis on it. Some books use a bracket, but most use a parenthesis. So this is all the numbers greater than negative 2. So I have a question for you. Is negative 2 included? The answer is no, because a parenthesis is used. So it's simply all the numbers greater than negative 2. And you might say, oh, infinity is included. We don't really say that because infinity is not a number. It's more of a concept. Okay? Let's try this one below here. So in this case, well, it's just the opposite, right? There's no lowest number, but there's certainly a highest number. That highest number is positive 1. So we do this. We put a comma one and then a bracket because there's a highest number, right? Now, you might guess that we put an infinity symbol here because we keep going to the left. But we want to tell the reader that we want to go in the negative direction. That is, we want all the negative numbers, right? So instead of using a positive infinity, what we do is we write a negative infinity and a parenthesis on that negative infinity, okay? So this would denote all the numbers less than one and also including one because there's a bracket on that positive one. So once again, the lowest number is always on the left, the highest number is always on the right, and if there is no highest number, you get an infinity symbol, and if there's no lowest number, you get a negative infinity symbol. Now, finally, what about this last example? Well, basically, all numbers are included, right? There's no lowest number and there's no highest number. So, combining the two ideas above, here's what we write. We write parentheses, negative infinity, comma, and what do you think's coming next? Infinity. So this denotes all the real numbers. So we say all real numbers. So sometimes in books you see people write out all real numbers. Other times they use interval notation and they simply write negative infinity to infinity. Okay? So interval notation is really commonly used when we solve inequalities. And we'll do that in a video very soon. See you next time.